Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel, and here I am going to explain chapter 3 of computer, more on Windows 10 in detail line by line. Listen to my explanation and follow the pages of your book and underline the sentences and read thoroughly after listening to the explanation. It is page 23. Chapter 3, more on Windows 10. Microsoft Windows is the most commonly used operating system. You know that computer cannot function without the operating system. And Microsoft Windows is the most commonly used OS, that is operating system. It is a type of graphical user interface. Not that based on character, but it is based on graphical user interface. There are several versions of Windows, such as Windows 98, 2000, Windows XP, Windows Vista, etc. And Microsoft Windows 10 is the latest version till date. Graphical user interface means there are some graphics, that is pictures, which help us to communicate with the computer. So if it is asked, what are the different versions of Windows? You can name any 2, any 4, any 1 as per asked in the question. Like Windows 98, 2000, XP or Vista. And if it is asked which is the latest version of Windows, it is Windows 10. And Windows, Microsoft Windows is a dash based operating system, then your answer will be graphical user interface. Next quick fact is on booting. When we switch on the computer, it takes a little time to start. Now why it actually takes a time? Because it loads the operating system, so that our computer is ready for our use. This process is called booting. So if it is given like this, when we switch on the computer, it takes a little time to load the operating system, which is called dash, then your answer will be booting. Next is starting Windows. The first screen that appears when we start the computer, the first screen that appears is the desktop. So the picture, figure 3.1, you can see that this is the desktop. And here are the icons. The down bottom, you see, have the task bar, and this is the desktop background. Now let us turn to page 24 of your book. On top, you see Windows desktop. It has two components, icons and taskbar. I have shown you the icons in figure in the previous page. Those small graphics or images, these are called icons. So if it is asked, the small graphics or images on Windows desktops are called dash, answer will be icons. So what are icons? These are small graphics or images. Next, in this quick fact, it is written that this desktop background is the image that appears at the back of our screen. And what do you think, children? Can we change this desktop background again and again according to our choice? Yes, definitely we can change this background image. Whenever we want, we can change. So if a true false is given that we cannot change the desktop background, then your answer will be definitely false, because we can change it anytime, any number of times as per our choice. Then is the taskbar. Which one is the taskbar? I have shown you that this is located at the bottom of the desktop. So the bar at the bottom of the desktop is called dash. Answer will be taskbar. In the taskbar, there are several things. Like you see, extreme left side, you have the start button. Just beside that, you have the search box. Here you have the pinned application. If you see this figure 3.3, these are the pinned application. Then to the right of that, you have the notification area, and extreme right, you have the show desktop. These options we will read in detail. Next is the start button. Now this start button, which is located extreme left, is probably the most commonly used button on the Windows desktop. Now when we click on this start button, this kind of menu opens, from where we can choose our options. These options provide access to the various apps that are present inside the computer. By scrolling with the help of the mouse, we can scroll up and down and then choose the one which we want to start. The level view of start is to show on the right side. Next, come to page 25. Now you all know that apps means application software, and Microsoft now calls all the program or all software on our computer apps. Next is search box. Just beside the start button in figure 3.3, you can see you have the search box. Here we can quickly search. We have to type anything with the help of the keyboard and we can search anything. Search the computer as well as the internet. Then we have the pinned application just beside search box. So many applications are pinned together. Pinned application actually means it holds all the icons. Whichever application is open, they are kept in the pin icon. Pinning a program in Windows 10 means you can always have a shortcut to it within easy reach. All the programs, whichever the user was using, all those things are kept there. And if we click and unpin them, then that particular application will open up. So therefore, it provides a shortcut to us. So always have a shortcut and helps us to find out or reach that thing very easily. Answer will be pinning. Then is the notification area. Just beside pin application, you have the notification area. You can relate these descriptions with the help of figure 3.3 on page 24. It helps you to understand in a better way. Notification area is located at the right end of the taskbar. And with the help of this, we can view programs and see the tasks that are running in the background. Next is using Show Desktop. It is possible to view the desktop when many windows are open. Next we have changing the position of the taskbar. You know the bar at the bottom of the desktop is called the taskbar. Now we will know about whether we can change the position of the taskbar or not. Yes, definitely we can change the position of the taskbar. By default, from the beginning, what we can see is that the position of the taskbar is at the bottom edge of the screen, down below, bottom edge. But we can change its location, change its position. There are the steps. You see, click on the blank space. Then you hold the primary mouse button and then drag the mouse pointer to the place on the screen where you want the taskbar. Suppose the taskbar is here at the bottom. Now, using the mouse, you can drag it to some other place like top, right, left, anywhere. In this way, you can just drag the mouse pointer. You know, mouse is a pointing device. So, with the help of the mouse pointer, you can drag it and place it where you want the taskbar to be shown. And immediately, the taskbar will be shown there. In figure 3.6, you can see the taskbar is placed on the top of the desktop. Next, turn to page 26 of your book. There is a check your progress. Answers are already provided earlier through CampusCare or NTAB. Now, come to the point that is changing the desktop background. The background image on the computer screen is called the desktop background. Different images are kept, so those images are called the desktop background. Now we can change this desktop background also as per our liking and choice. What are the steps? Right click on the blank area. Blank area means where you find no icon, only simply it's a blank area. There you make a right click with the help of your mouse. When you make the right click, this kind of menu appears. From there you choose the personalize option. Personalize means they will give you certain choice, certain background icons will open up and any one of those background you can choose and keep it as your own desktop's background. Then you click the background option in the left panel. Here in the left panel you click the background option. Every illustration is provided beside the description in your book in figure 3.8. You can take the help of this illustration to understand the steps. So from this background, page will come up which will allow you to see so many background pictures. You can choose any photo from there, any picture from there, and then click on the box underneath background. Just below that you have another box, click on that. And then the fifth step is click and choose any one of the available pictures. And when you finally select them, the desktop appears on your screen. Next page, page 27. You see again the figures and steps are given. Any one you can choose. Similarly, we can also keep some wallpapers. These are actually the wallpaper. In this way, we can set the wallpaper or the desktop background. Now, children, tell me one answer of the question. If I ask you that the position of the taskbar can never be changed, is it true or false? It is false, because yes, we can change the position. So if in the question it is mentioned that we cannot change, then it is false. Similarly, if it is asked that the desktop background we can change, yes, it is true, we can change the desktop background. So thorough reading of the chapter will help you to answer this type of inside short questions. Next comes changing the window's color. Window colors refer to the color of the taskbar, start menu and borders of the window. So if we change the color, we will see that the color of the taskbar, start menu and borders will be changed. What are the steps? Make a right click on the blank area at the desktop. Then a menu appears. Now when you click on the personalize option, what happens? You see illustration is given on figure 3.11 on page 27. So this personalize option comes. Every time personalize option you will get to see. Because personalize means something the user can set for his computer or her computer out of his or her own choice. Next. Then the personalize settings. In the personalized window, left click or tap on the color feature. You see the color feature here. See the illustration is given, figure 3.12. From there, choose the show color option for start. Start means start menu, start button, taskbar and action center feature. When you choose these things, then the color window appears. Choose any one color. Now from the list of color, number 5 step, you see. Now from the list of colors, left click or tap on a color that you want to see, you wish as per your own choice, and then close the settings window. And after that, that particular color you will see on the start button, taskbar and the borders. Next is setting screen saver. Now what is a screen saver, children? First you should know that one. Screen saver is an animated image that appears on your computer screen when you have left it idle for some time. Sometimes what we do is, suppose we are working on the computer, we are the users, we are working on the computer and someone calls us and suddenly we leave the work unfinished without even saving and go away. So what happens? Our computer is left idle because at that time no work is getting done on the computer. So, an animated image appears which does not allow the other users to see that what work was going on. So, it is screen saver. It is used to maintain privacy while not working on the screen. While we are not working, sitting in front of the computer and working on it, then this kind of animated image appears. So this is screen saver. You have to underline screen saver. So dash is an animated image that appears when the computer is left idle for some time. Idle means when we are not using it. When it is free, then your answer will be screen saver. How can you set the screen saver? There are steps. But before doing the steps, I would like to tell you that the original screen will come back as soon as you touch the computer or press anything in the keyboard or move the mouse, then that original previous screen on which you are working, that thing will come up. Next, see the steps to change the screen saver. Type the screen saver in the search box next to the start button. You have to type in the search box screen saver, then click on the screen saver option. then the screensaver window will appear. You can relate it with the figure 3.15. Select the screensaver from the screensaver drop-down list. In the wait box, specify the minutes. That means after how many minutes the screensaver will appear, this you have to provide. Then go to the preview button. Preview will help you to see it before applying. So before finally applying it, if you want to see, then how can you see? You can see with the help of the preview button. And then you click on apply and then click on OK button. And this is how you can set the screensaver. So, and I have already told you that screensaver is used to maintain privacy while not working on the screen. Next is working with an app. You know, any software program or any computer program today is called an app. So now let us do that one on page 29. Working with an app. Whenever you open an app file or folder, it appears on the screen in a box or frame which is called an application or app window. The small box inside which it appears is a app window. And we can move them, change their size, or just make them go away. What are the parts of an app window? First is menu bar. It is located just below the title bar. And what does it contain? It contains other menus like file, edit, view. So if it is asked which bar contains different other menus, the answer will be menu bar. Some kind of match the following can also be given from this one. Title bar. Which bar displays the name of the window? Dash. Dash bar displays the name of the window. Answer will be title bar. Minimize button means you can reduce the size of the window to the taskbar by using this minimize button. You see, it is given in this box number 3, where it is written number 3, that is the minimize symbol. Maximize, it is number 4. You see this one, figure 3.17 on your book. Then close button, that is this cross which you can see extreme right. Then you have the scroll bar by the side which helps you to go up and down. And then the borders, which is the limiting area of a window. It shows the limiting area. It gives like a square within which you have to work. So these are the various parts of a window. I have explained you some kind of matching or name the following. This type of few inside questions can be given. Then this quick tip, this thing is a restoration button. By clicking on this, you can control the window. It appears when the window appears in full screen, and when you click on this, it makes the window smaller than the maximum, and this button again changes to maximize. Then there is a quick recap. I will not explain you quick recap, but you have to read this quick recap for various other short questions. You can see some things are already underlined. If I ask you, suppose the taskbar can be dragged to any dash sides of the desktop. How many sides? You see 4 sides. You see it is written 4 sides. So this type of inside questions you can prepare. Then is dialog box. The last point of the quick recap. This is not done in the chapter, so I am explaining it. A dialog box is a special type of window that asks you a question, allows you to select options to perform a task or provide you with information. So whenever we click something, this kind of dialog box appears, and from there we can select various options and then get our work done. So here the chapter ends. I will stop my explanation of chapter 3 here. Question answers of exercise were already given through Campus Care or NTAP. So children, please read, prepare the chapter, read the chapter thoroughly, follow the explanation, prepare inside question answers as I have discussed, and also this exercise questions. Thank you for watching the video.